that statement. I now give the floor to the representative of Indonesia.
Mr. President, Indonesia's position on the situation in Venezuela has always been consistent, clear, and principled. We have had the opportunity to express our position on this particular matter a number of times. Indonesia regrets that we cannot achieve unity in the Security Council on how to address the situation in Venezuela. The fact that we are having two separate draft resolutions is a clear evidence of the lack of sense of unity among the Council members. Which is sad. I must humbly submit in my less than 2 months in the Council that this is a sad day for the international community, particularly for the people of Venezuela. This is undoubtedly a collective failure, a failure of us 15 that are seated in this table. Because we all came here today knowing that we would not reach the needed consensus for the adoption of a resolution. I would like to address the failure to reach consensus solution as follows. In the first instances, both draft resolutions are incomplete, as they are not comprehensive enough and have become overly politicized. Thus, both drafts would neither be useful nor helpful to the course of ensuring the interests of the people of Venezuela. Both drafts give little attempt to finding a consensus on this highly sensitive matter. The need for flexibility in the Council and priority on reducing tension in Venezuela are of the essence. We would have liked to see more balanced and all-embracing draft. We would also have valued a more thorough consultation preparatory process involving all parties in the discussion. Now, Mr. President, the situation in Venezuela is still worrying, and thus the need for the Council to be united and take the right actions comprehensively and not exacerbate the situation. In doing so, Indonesia has always taken the principled stance that in order to achieve durable solution, the following points should be taken into account. First, the principle of non-interference, sovereignty, and territorial integrity in line with the UN Charter should be honored. It should always be a starter in discussing any issues in the framework of the United Nations. Second, any solution should focus on an inclusive political dialogue involving all parties. There is an urgent need to address the large trust deficit, and therefore, we call all parties to accept the good offices offered by the Secretary General and restrain from taking action that will further deteriorate the already fragile situation on the ground. Third, there is urgency to address humanitarian need of the people of Venezuela, which is in dire need of humanitarian assistance. The United Nations must play an important role in deliverance and organizing support for humanitarian assistance. Fourth, the plight of Venezuela refugees affecting neighboring countries has to be urgently addressed. Now, this 4 point should be the element of a good consensual Security Council resolution. And without these elements, Indonesia refused to accept or reject both resolutions because they are flawed. If we really care about the people of Venezuela, then we should have a united front and find a joint solution. We continuously expressed the view of having a united front, and we have not done so. Mr. President, in all honesty, I have to admit that my delegation is starting to believe that dialogue and negotiation are a luxury here in the Council. I was wondering as to how the Council can promote dialogue for a universally acceptable solution if its members have difficulty to sit together and have a dialogue in finding common ground. We beseech our colleagues to put aside their differences. Now is not the time to be divided by political rhetoric. Let us spare no effort to ensure that we will be part of the solution and not be part of the problem. Despite the deeply diverging views in the Council, Indonesia is of the view that it is still possible for us to arrive at a consensus in the future, as long as the Council lives up to its mandate and responsibility. We have still an unfinished business, and that is to assist Venezuela and its people to find a peaceful solution to their current challenges. I thank you, Mr. President.